Since the 1960s, we have launched dozens of missions to Mars, attempting to learn more about our red neighbor. We have discovered incredible things about the barren planet, the most spectacular being that it once was a world rich with flowing water. 3.8 billion years ago, the now dry, toxic planet may have been as habitable as Earth. But as time went on, dramatic changes caused the Martian seas and lakes to disappear. Today, there is not flowing water, but instead drifting sand, moving across dry, dusty rocks, all of which is wrapped in a thin, cold atmosphere. We have all seen the incredible photos beamed back by the rovers and landers exploring Mars. But now we can enjoy a second human sense, because NASA's Perseverance Rover has the capability of not only seeing the Martian environment, but also listening to it. Perseverance carries two off-the-shelf commercial microphones. The first is built into its body and was used during its entry, descent, and landing, while the second is built into its supercam, an instrument mounted to a long-necked mast that examines rock and soil with a camera, laser, and spectrometer, seeking organic compounds that could be related to past life on Mars. By sending microphones, scientists will, for the first time, be able to directly study how sound propagates through the Martian atmosphere. Previous attempts to send a microphone to Mars have all failed over the years, but we have had a taste of what the surface sounds like. Back in 2018, NASA's InSight lander picked up eerie sounds from Mars using its seismometer sensor, which was at the time hailed as the first sound ever recorded from the red planet. But rather than relying on a seismometer sensor, Perseverance can directly capture the real thing using dedicated commercial microphones, allowing the listener to hear the sounds of Mars as if they were there standing upon the red sands of the Jezero crater. When we hear sound, what we are really experiencing is our eardrums vibrating. That vibration comes from waves of pressure that travel to our ears from the source of the sound. To get to our ears, the waves need something to travel through, like air, liquid, or even solids, and this would be the same on Mars. Compared to Earth, however, the Martian atmosphere is entirely different in temperature, density, and chemistry. So if you could stand on Mars and listen to me without a helmet on, I would sound like this.
My voice would be a quieter, more muffled version of what you would hear on Earth, and you would have to wait slightly longer to hear it.
But the biggest change to audio would be to the high pitch sounds. The noises that we hear every day, like bird songs, whistles, or bells, would be almost inaudible. This is due to the 96% carbon dioxide within the red planet's atmosphere, which absorbs high-pitched sound and leaves only the lower-pitched rumbles. So as we listen to the best recordings Perseverance has captured so far, remember that what you are hearing has come from another planet. It might seem similar to sounds found here on Earth, but these are the sounds of a world that at its closest is 33.9 million miles away, or 54.6 million kilometers away. The first recording we will experience was captured in February 2021, just 4 Martian days after Perseverance had landed. What you're about to hear is the rumble of otherworldly wind blowing across the dry sands of a desert world. Another benefit of having a microphone attached to the rover is that engineers can listen once it has performed its tasks, allowing them to understand and possibly even diagnose problems with the robot, much like a mechanic might listen closely to an engine to know what's wrong with it. In this recording, we can hear Perseverance driving over a section of the Jezero crater. It almost sounds brutal on the rover as it clunks and bangs across the relentless, rocky terrain. One big surprise of the mission was when Perseverance heard the hum of the Ingenuity drone's rotors buzzing in the distance. Ingenuity traveled to Mars attached to the belly of Perseverance and was designed as a demonstration to test the first powered flight on Mars. If you listen closely, the hum of the helicopter can be heard faintly above the sound of Martian wind. $3.8 billion years ago, this red planet was wet and possibly even habitable. Today, Mars is a barren desert world that is, for now, at least, only inhabited by robots. We may not be able to hear the sound of flowing water across its red rocks, but what you have just listened to is nonetheless the sound of an alien planet and a robot exploring it.